Greetings, my friends! Welcome back to my channel! It is time for another Iron Man unboxing. In this beautiful box, we will find the Iron Man Mark 85 from the movie Avengers Endgame, and I can't wait to share it with you. This figure was made by Hot Toys, and that also means I had to wait a long time till it finally came to me. But now it's here. Time for a first close look. It is easy to see. The people at Hot Toys did their very best. Again, I have to add. The paint job is just amazing. Red and gold. Brilliant colors. And I guess I should mention, most parts of this figure are die-cast metal. So this guy is quite heavy. Don't drop him. So far, every Iron Man from Hot Toys came with some extra hands. But this guy has even an additional arm. And he really needs it, because he's got the Infinity Stones. So I guess it's time for a quick arm change. Let's see if I'm able to manage it. Okay then, here we go. It shouldn't be too complicated. And if you are following my channel for a while, you know it's not the first time I'm dealing with stuff like this. The arm and the hands are not the only things that can be removed. As always, you can remove the chest plate. Well, yeah, it's nice. But I don't know why anyone should display the figure like this. Again, Hot Toys added some scratches and dirt to the metal surface. It makes this Iron Man look used, like a real machine. I have to admit I'm not really a big fan of that, but I got used to it over the years. Let's move to the other side of the body. We still got one hand to swap. I should mention that the hands are not die-cast metal. They are one of the few pieces that are still plastic. Too bad. But to be honest, it's really hard to see any difference. If you are enjoying this video so far, please remember you can always like and subscribe. And you better do if you want to see more stuff like this. Meanwhile, I take another look at the box, because I've got this feeling there's something else. Okay, we have a stand, no big surprise. And then there's the Nano Lightning Refocuser. Yes, seriously, it's not a name I made up. It's really called like this in the manual. Well, whatever the name is, if you saw the movie, you know you don't want your Iron Man to come without it. So let's attach it to the figure. This is also one of the pieces that is not die-cast metal. And here, you can really see it. But at least for me, this is a very important accessory. So I just have to accept it. Okay then, here we go. Finally, in all its glory, the Iron Man Mark 85 from Avengers Endgame. If you are an Iron Man fan like me, there isn't much I have to tell you. This is a great figure. Hot Toys did their very best again. And since this is one of the last versions of Iron Man we saw in the movies, I think the Iron Man line of figures from Hot Toys will slowly come to an end. But who knows? There's still a battle-damaged version of this guy coming out soon. When the first people got their Iron Man from Hot Toys, some claimed the Tony Stark head wouldn't be any good. So Hot Toys decided to change it with a later shipment. Well, this is the head I've got, and it looks pretty good. But I've got this feeling I've seen this head before on some other figure. Okay, my friends, that is all I wanted to show you this time. As always, I didn't put the batteries in the figure, because it's just too much work. But if you still want to see the Iron Man all light up, let me know in the comments, and maybe I will change my mind. If you are still watching till the very end, thanks a lot. It really means a lot to me. Stay tuned. I will talk to you again very soon.